Hiya, I'm Heartbeats, also known as Hannah. For 13 years, the Tories have promised to fix this country. They're not interested in ruling, only ruining for personal and financial gain. The NHS is crumbling even more so than ever before. Rent prices are spiralling, mortgage rates are out of control. Kids can't afford to eat at lunch, and families are using food banks more than ever. And by the way, the Tories openly laugh at people for doing so. This is not my hyperbole. This is fact. Go to a hospital, visit a school, get out on the street. It's all there for you to see. And what do Rishi Sunak and Chemical Badenoch do instead of even attempting to fix the myriad of big issues in this country? They start a culture war aimed at trans folk and migrants to distract and divide. I'm not even kidding. The Tories intend to fight the next election on these two issues. Again, fact. And all to get back into power to line their pockets further, and worse, they're unelected. And as for Labour and their retraction of self-ID for trans folk, which by the way, is disgusting. And providing an open apology to Rosie the transphobe Duffield from Wes, I'm not a Tory, streeting this past week. Their shift to the right is nearly complete. Enough is enough. I will not be used as a political football, and I will defend anyone who they attack. So what can we do? First off, get out there and meet trans folk in your community. Show them they're supported, show them they're loved. Show them that the average person on the street does not care which toilet they use. Secondly, if you have a voice, use it. Email your MP, especially if they're a Conservative. Be loud, be vocal about your allyship. Speak to friends and colleagues. If they have an issue with trans folk, ask them how I, Hannah, in my pink dungarees and lovely floaty top, do you like it? I like it. I'm in any way a threat to them. And thirdly, I call for a campaign of non-violent civil disobedience. Our generations act up, if you like. I want to organise flash drag performances in places like Rishi Sunak's home constituency of Richmond to raise awareness of what a transphobic fascist he is. It is in this vein that I want to start making trips to Richmond, and I'll start grassroots campaigning for trans rights. I will politely and calmly ask people on the street questions not only about trans rights, but also the overall state of the country we're living in. And if they're happy, we will take pictures of me, a trans woman and human fucking being. See what I did there? I'm not dancer, I'm human. Enjoying my time and sharing trans joy. I will then send these to the unelected transphobic schoolboy in a posh suit, Sunak, on Twitter, one by one. Basically, I intend to harangue him with as much support as I can gather, until the government backs down, and that's with your support too. I'm also thinking a trip to Canterbury to organise a trans rights party right outside Rosie Duffield's office, as well as the same outside Carl McCartney's office, the Tory MP for Lincoln who blocked me on Twitter for questioning his support of Nigel Farage and Dan Wootton. Basically, any act of non-violent civil disobedience goes here. I will not be used as a political football. I will not be used to win elections, to bring more corrupt politicians to power. Speak up and speak out. My inbox is always open. If any of you need to ask questions, especially if there are any trans folk out there who are struggling, I am here. As the wonderful India Willoughby said this past week, we are the new suffragettes. We fight not against feminism, but for and to further the cause of feminism for everyone. Stay strong. state fucking proud. We will beat them. It's going to be hard, but we will beat them. You can follow me on Twitter at Proud Transmiss. For any updates, don't be scared to drop me a line. I love you all. Thank you for coming. I'll leave you to the music.